In this video, I'll be solving the questions from 14 to 18 of exercise 7.4, chapter 7, integrals. We have to find the integral of the given functions. Here, the given function is 1 by under root 8 plus 3x minus x square. So let us write I is equal to integral dx divided by, we have to bring this in the form square root of a square minus x square. So let me complete the squares. So under root, I'm writing it as 8 minus of x square minus dx. Here I am multiplying and dividing by 2. 2 into 3 by 2 and adding and subtracting 3 by 2 the whole square. So, this is equal to integral dx divided by square root of 8 plus 9 by 4 minus, here we have completed the square. We have got x minus 3 by 2 the whole square. X minus 3 by 2 the square. So, this is equal to integral dx by square root of 8 plus 9 by 4 is 41 by 4. 41 by 4, I am writing it as root 41 by 2 the whole square minus of x minus 3 by 2 the whole square. So, this is of the form dx divided by square root of a square minus x square, which is nothing but sine inverse of x by a. This is equal to sine inverse of, in place of x we have x minus 3 by 2 and in place of a we have root 41 by 2 plus c. Since you can write it inside the bracket, integral dx by under root a square minus x square is equal to sine inverse of x by a plus c. We can simplify this. This is equal to sine inverse of 2x minus 3 by root 41 plus c. So we have got the integral of the given function. I hope this is clear. The next question is 1 by square root of x minus a into x minus b. So let me write I is equal to integral dx divided by square root of x square. This we have x square minus of a plus b into x minus ab. So we have to complete the square inside the root. So I am writing it separately. We have x square minus of a plus b the whole into x plus ab is equal to x square minus of, I am multiplying and dividing by 2. 2 into half a plus b into x plus a plus b by 2 the whole square minus a plus b by 2 the whole square plus ab, which is already there. So this is equal to, here we can see that the square is completed. This is equal to x minus a plus b by 2 the whole square minus a square plus b square plus 2ab, I'm sorry, divided by 4 plus, let me write one more step. This is equal to x minus a plus b by 2 the whole square minus of a square plus b square. If I take minus, it minus outside will be plus 2ab minus 4ab. So it is minus 2ab by 4. So this is nothing but x minus a plus b by 2 the whole square minus a minus b by 2 the whole square. So we have the given function as I is equal to integral dx divided by under root this part. x minus a plus b by 2 the whole square minus a minus b by 2 the whole square. So let me write it the next page. So we have I is equal to integral dx divided by square root of x minus a plus b by 2 the whole square minus a minus b by 2 the whole square. This is of the form integral dx by square root of x square minus a square, which is nothing but log mod x plus square root of x square minus a square. So this is in place of x we have x minus a plus b by 2 plus square root of, if we simplify this we have got this entire term from x minus a into x minus b. So here we can write under root x square minus of a plus b into x plus ab plus c. Since integral dx by square root of x square minus a square is equal to log mod x plus square root of x square minus a square plus c. So we have got the integral of the given function. Now the next question is you have to find the integral of 4x plus 1 divided by root of 2x square plus x minus 3. Here we can easily do integration by substitution. If you see here, if we take t as 2x square plus x minus 3, then dt will be 4x plus 1 into dx. So let me write I is equal to integral 4x plus 1 divided by under root 2x square plus x minus 3 into dx. We can put 2x square plus x minus 3 as t, so that on differentiating 4x plus 1 into dx is equal to dt. So we have I is equal to integral dt by root t, which is equal to t raised to minus half plus 1 is half. It is 2 t raised to half plus t. Let us substitute for t. This is equal to 2 under root 2x square plus x minus 3 plus c. The next question is we have to find the integral of x plus 2 divided by under root x square minus 1. So let us take I is equal to integral x by under root x square minus 1 dx plus 2 integral dx by root of square minus 1. So for this part we can use integration by substitution, and for this we have the standard formula. So let us put x square minus 1 as t, so that x dx will be equal to dt by 2. So we have I is equal to integral dt by root t plus 2 integral dx by root of square minus 1. So this is equal to half into 2 root t plus integral dx by square minus 1 is log mod x plus root of x square minus 1 plus c. Since we know that integral dx by root of x square minus a square is equal to log mod x plus root of square minus a square plus c. So this is equal to, for t we can substitute in terms of x, root of x square minus 1, this 2 will go, plus 2 times log mod x plus root of x square minus 1 plus, so we have got the integral of the given function. The next question is we have to find the integral of 5x minus 2 divided by 1 plus 2x plus 3 square. When we have functions of this form, we have to write the numerator in terms of derivative of the denominator plus the constant. So on simplifying you will be able to understand. So let me take I is equal to integral 5x minus 2 divided by 3x squared plus 2x plus 1 dx. So you have to take the numerator as, let 5x minus 2 is equal to a into d by dx of the denominator, 3x squared plus 2x plus 1 plus, that is 5x minus 2 is equal to a into 6x plus 2 plus, so here we have to compare the coefficients of x and constant. So let me first compare coefficient of x. From that we will get the value of, when we compare coefficient of x, we have 5 is equal to 6a, or a is equal to 5 by 6. Next, let us compare the constants. On comparing constants, we have minus 2 is equal to 2a plus b. From this, we have minus 2 is equal to, a is 5 by 6, equal to 5 by 3 plus b. Therefore, b is equal to minus 2 minus 5 by 3, it is minus 11 by 3. So we have I is equal to a into 6x plus 2. A we got 5 by 6. We can write I is equal to 5 by 6 integral 6x plus 2 by 3x square plus 2x plus 1 dx minus 11 by 3 integral dx by 3x square plus 2x plus 1. I hope this is clear. So let us take I as sum of two integrals I1 and I2. That is, I1 is the first integral and I2 is the second integral, so that it will be easy for us to solve. So let us take I1 as 5 by 6 integral 6x plus 2 by 3x square plus 2x plus 1 into dx. Let me move on to the next page. So let us take I1 is equal to 5 by 6 integral 6x plus 2 divided by 3x square plus 2x plus 1. 3x square plus 2x plus 1 into dx. So here we can put 3x square plus 2x plus 1 is equal to t, so that 6x plus 2 into dx will be equal to dt. Therefore, I1 will be 5 by 6 integral dt by t. So that is equal to 5 by 6 log mod t plus c. Let me write c1. So let us substitute for t. This is equal to 5 by 6 log mod 3x square plus 2x plus 1 plus c1. Now next let us take I2 as I2 is equal to minus 11 by 3 into integral dx by 3x square plus 2x plus 1. So let's take I2 is equal to minus 11 by 3 integral dx divided by 3x square plus 2x plus 1. So this is equal to minus 11 by 3, I'm let me take 3 outside, integral dx divided by x square plus 2 into 1 by 3x. Now I am adding and subtracting 1 by 9 plus 1 by 3. So this is equal to minus 11 by 9 integral dx divided by x plus 1 by 3 the whole square minus 1 by 9 plus 1 by 3 is plus 2 by 9. So plus root 2 by 3 the whole square. So this is nothing but minus 11 by 9 into integral dx by x square plus a square is 1 by a tan inverse of x by a into 1 by root 2 by 3 tan inverse of x plus 1 by 3 divided by root 2 by 3 plus c2. So this is equal to minus 11 by 3 root 2 tan inverse of 3x plus 1 by root 2 plus c2. So we have the integral of the given function I is sum of I1 and I2. So I is equal to 5 by 6 log mod 3x square plus 2x plus 1 minus 11 by 3 root 2 tan inverse of 3x plus 1 by root 2 plus c1 plus c2. I am writing it as c. So we got the integral of the given function. I hope this video was useful for you. Thank you for watching.